Welcome to Atalan.
Hi, welcome to Atalan. No one knows where it came from, but the crystal is supposed to be very powerful, some sort of interdimensional nexus. It's basically a doorway to a dimension full of high-density neutron stars. Thing is, if that doorway collapses, the gravitational forces would cause our universe to be pulled through. That's the remains of an old city built by aliens known as the Kree. From here, the Kree traveled to Earth to genetically alter a group of humans in hopes of using them as soldiers. Eventually, the Kree gave up on their experiments and left Earth, but the genetically altered humans remained behind. They became known as the Inhumans. Their first city was located on an island in the North Atlantic. But as mankind developed better forms of transportation, the Inhumans moved their city to a spot in the Himalayas. Finally, the pollution of Earth became too much for them, so they moved everything up here to the moon. Hey, it's what I'm here for.
You'll be traveling to the Shi'ar Empire for this next mission. It's located in a galaxy in another part of the universe. Once there, you'll need to lay hands on a shard of the Makran Crystal.
Will the Shi'ar be willing to part with it?
The crystal is very important to the Shi'ar, but we're good friends with their ruler, Lilandra. I don't think she'll mind giving it to us, especially once she learns how important it is in stopping Dr. Doom.
You X-Men are pretty well connected. You've even got buddies in other galaxies.
Xavier's the one who's close to Lilandra. They used to be good friends. Really good friends, if you catch my meaning.
Ooh, guess that means Lilandra's not gonna be some wrinkled old prune of a queen.
You can say that again, bub.
What is the Shi'ar Empire?
It's an ancient kingdom that spans entire galaxies and consists of thousands of different civilizations.
Are they peaceful?
They have had their periods of upheaval, usually due to struggles within the royal family. But for the most part, yes.
What exactly is this Makran crystal?
It houses a gateway into a universe filled with neutron stars. The power available there is beyond measure.
I can see how that would be useful in defeating Dr. Doom.
All right then. Get to Shi'ar and locate Lilandra as fast as you can. Once you've convinced her to give you the crystal, get back here pronto. Good luck.
Surrender immediately!
Well, well, well. What brings my fellow man to this distant galaxy? Don't you know? There's been a coup. Deathbird has taken the throne from her sister, Lilandra. Then you should be very motivated to see Lilandra back on the throne, because Deathbird certainly won't give you anything other than life in prison. Hold on! Remember, the only way to activate a force field is to find the console that operates it. Lilandra's a good friend of mine, and when a friend's in need, I make it a practice to lend a hand. Because heaven knows, there's been times when I needed help. Now come on, I can see you kids are gonna need a little help, so I'll travel a ways with you. Our first order of business is to get across this fighter bay in one piece.
Small fry. Oh! I wish we could have been friends.
Anybody else want some?
Well, my friends, this is where we part ways. I wish I could, but I have other things to attend to. But I'll tell you what. If you'll be willing to carry out a few objectives for me, I'll be happy to walk you through the ship over the radio. Great. Your first order of business will be to stop this ship. I'll be in touch with you when you get to engineering. Watch your back, my friends.
Ready? 3, 2, 1. There. The door's secure. Hey, who's that? Intruders! Let's split up!
Officially a loser. A new car, too?
Right.
Okie doke.
Go. Leave now, and I will not harm you. I am honor-bound to serve the Empress of Shi'ar, and that is Empress Deathbird. She has given me orders to destroy all invaders. Though it pains me, Lilandra is no longer on the throne. I take commands only from Empress Deathbird. Now please, go, or I shall be forced to use violence. Very well, then. You leave me no choice.
Thank you. light speed. Now, find the airlock that leads outside of the ship.
No, sir.
Technology a wonderful thing? Now you've got two objectives here. One is to find the communication dish and send a message to the starships that are still friendly to Lilandra. Have them come to this location and protect her. You have to destroy the battery of guns near your location. That'll protect the friendly ships that come in response to your message.
Is mine.
Go no further, humans. I am Starbolt, a member of the Shi'ar Imperial Guard. You stand in defiance of Empress Deathbird. I know I was one of the guards who helped her gain power, and I have no intention of letting her lose it. Which is exactly how we wanted it to appear. Warstar, attack!
Urgently require help.
Everybody look! I won! I won!
Go no further. I would...
Thank you.
Ships come to help Lalandra, they won't be easy targets.
The reports of humans on board ship are true. I would not have believed them capable of getting this far.
Nor I, Hasar. Humans are such inferior creatures. We are Imperial Guards, loyal to Empress Deathbird.
Yes. Without the help of the Imperial Guard, she would never have gained power. No. Most of them were fools who wouldn't listen to reason. Luckily, Guardian is loyal to the throne rather than to a person.
But we could have dealt with even the mighty Guardian, just as we're going to deal with you now. Give up all...
Dear sister is being questioned, and once we arrive at the homeworld, she will be placed on trial for crimes against the Empire, and then executed. Indeed I do, humans. I've spent months planning my rise to power, and I'm not about to lose now. So with the aid of the Makran Crystal, I will destroy you. The last vestiges of defiance to my absolute authority. You've not only defeated my Imperial Guard, you've defeated me! Never. I am the Empress. Kneel before me! You lie. If I am to be denied, then I will stop dear sister as well by destroying this entire ship.
What are you doing here? Forget about me, there's no time. You have to save the ship. My life is not important. There are thousands of others who need you to stop the self-destruct mechanism.
Thank you.
you think you can best me, eh, humans? Well, you're far too late. The self-destruct timer has been activated. That's where you're wrong. By destroying this ship, I'll have a little vengeance. Now, to smash this console, so there's no way for you to shut it off. Fools! I always have an escape plan.
Possess the first item needed to defeat Dr. Doom. Lockjaw will now create a portal that you may use any time to return to our base on Attilan. You did well. Obtaining the Makran crystal under those conditions was quite impressive. Yes. But there is still one item you must obtain. The Muonic Inducer. It is the device Galactus uses to assimilate the energy of a planet when he devours it. He is about to attack a planet populated by the Skrull, a race who has long sought to conquer the Earth. If you wish to leave now, see the dog Lockjaw. Or, should you desire additional information, talk to the Black Widow.
About to be sent to the homeworld of the Skrull. There you need to steal a device called the Muonic Inducer from Galactus, who is presently attacking the Skrull planet.
Why is Galactus at war with the Skrull?
He's not. Galactus is there to consume the planet.
Whoa! This dude eats planets? I gotta get a picture of that.
He doesn't really eat them. He has machines that convert the planet into energy he can absorb. One of those devices is the Muonic Inducer.
I wouldn't think old Galactus is going to be too happy with us trying to steal one of his toys.
No, he won't be. Which is why I'd strongly advise against any confrontation with him. Galactus is one of the most powerful beings we've ever encountered.
That would explain why he feeds off entire planets. But how does he choose which worlds to consume?
He has a herald for that. A scout who determines which planet's next on the menu.
Well, at least we can count on the Skrull to help us out.
Not necessarily. The Skrull are a warlike people who've attacked the Earth several times before. They'll most likely see you as enemies.
Wonderful. So if Mr. Universe doesn't completely crush us, the Skrull will be happy to finish the job.
Yes. Is that a problem?
No. Just wanted to make sure what the teams are.
Well, good. Now get moving.
Team? You now stand on the Skrull homeworld. They are an alien culture who've tried to enslave humanity several times. They'll attack you, but remember, Your primary goal is to locate Galactus so you can take his mnemonic inducer. Planet's magnetic field into a shield he uses to protect himself. On the off chance you'll have to face Galactus, it'd be in your best interest to take down these generators.
Embarrassing, little boy. What are you doing here, humans? Are you the ones who brought Galactus down upon our world?
Why they are here doesn't matter. Let's destroy them anyway.
Agreed, Pybok. They will be forever the enemy.
Stay your hand, my brave warriors. We may have use for these creatures. Humans, I propose a bargain. If you are truly here to battle Galactus, then you will require knowledge that I alone possess. Knowledge of a weakness of the Planet Eater. In return for this knowledge, all I ask is that you open the main hangar door so that my ship can escape the destruction of this planet. Trust me, humans. Your lives depend on it.
I am Pybok, the Power Skrull. Biogenetic engineering has granted me incredible strength and superhuman endurance. You would do well to choose me as...
I am the Super Skrull, the mightiest of all Skrull warriors. I possess powers equal to the Fantastic Four. It would be a grave mistake not to choose me as your...
I am Pybok.
I just wish we could have been friends.
Good guys.
Everybody look! I won! I won!
So, you still live. You humans are more resourceful than I'd thought. Fools! You should already know that Galactus has no weakness. With the thousands of civilizations he's faced, do you think he'd still be alive today if he was not invincible? Yes. And I'm also going to have you destroyed. Super Skrull! Pybok, attack!
The Empress is wise and just. We are honor-bound to obey her.
Yes. And now we have the privilege of carrying out her order to kill the humans.
Oh!
target me!
That was hardly worth it.
Were weak at best.
Of course.
Sure.
Okie doke.
This is quite agreeable.
Thank you.
dares to interfere with the mighty Galactus. Mere humans are beneath my notice. Punishers, dispatch these interlopers immediately. I have important matters to attend to.
on a Skrull world. No doubt you've come to try to save my kinsmen. Well, don't waste your time. They're not worth it. They forced me into the Super Skrull program, where I was tortured with medical procedures and drugs. The pain I endured was more than any creature should have to suffer. They are all guilty. All of them! Now stand aside, weaklings. I'll not be denied my vengeance.
On the double. Uatu says we're running out of time. Doom's beginning to cause real damage with his use of Odin's power.
Ready for round two?
Sure.
That's a big deal.
Muscle-bound maniac would have killed me. No, no, I must show you my appreciation. Here, take. Of course I insist. And thank you again. I will never forget your kindness.
And now I'm better at doing whatever it is.
Thank you.
Colonel Fury sent me to aid you in battling my old master. But first, allow me to use the power cosmic to heal you. True, he is mighty. But if we work together, we can slow him down. The Inducer is what powers the three machines. But you won't be able to get to him until Galactus is out of the way. Growing weaker, but once again he is attempting to destroy us with an energy blast. I will try to distract him and cause it to detonate early.
Right.
if you see some.
Very impressive. I would not have thought you'd survive an encounter with Galactus. But you must return to Earth now. Doom has grown quite adept with his newfound powers, and he has shown little restraint in their use. Soon, he will begin to damage the very fabric of the universe. Once you are done here in Atalan, see Lockjaw. He will send you to Earth.
Somebody take a picture.